song tells a story. And behind every great song, there's a story to be told.
Miami, FLA. Hitchhiked her way across USA. Plucked her eyebrows on the way. Shaved her legs and then he was a she. She says, hey babe, take a walk on the wild side. Said, hey honey, take a walk on the wild side. She was everybody's darling, but she never lost her head. Even when she was given head, she says, hey babe, take a walk on the wild side. Said, hey babe, take a walk on the wild side. And the colored girls go do 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 do. Gave it away. Everybody had to pay and pay. A hustle here and a hustle there. New York City is the place where they said, hey babe, take a walk on the wild side. I said, hey Joe, take a walk on the wild side. Just speeding away. Thought she was Jim Dean for a day. Then I guess she had to crash. Valium would have helped that fashion. Said, hey babe, take a walk on the wild side. I said, hey honey, take a walk on the wild side. And the colored girls say, do 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 do.
Well, my name is Hollywood Lawn, and yes, that song is completely true about me hitchhiking from Miami. Hitchhiking at the age of, which is not easy, in 1963, for a boy, and I plucked, well, actually, I don't know which I did first, which was I think I plucked my eyebrows first, and then shaved my legs. I don't know how to, which, plucked her eyebrows along, shaved her legs. Hey, yeah, the song's right. Plucked her eyebrows along the way, shaved her legs, and then he was she. Yes, the song's right. After hitchhiking, what, 1,500 miles, I landed in New York City. Not thinking, but knowing that I was a she.
You attract a lot of those people up at the factory, though, in your films, no?
What, closet queens? No, I
don't. Not closet queens, drag queens.
Drag queens, oh, but I don't, the people we use aren't really drag queens. Because drag queens are people who just sort of dress up, you know, for, like 8 hours a day or something like that. And the kind of people we really use are people who think they, are really girls and stuff, so that's sort of different.
All the characters in Walk on the Wild Side could be found at Andy Warhol's studio, The Factory, in the late 60s. By then, pop artist Warhol had largely abandoned painting to produce a series of underground films with his director, Paul Morrissey.
Incest, lesbianism.
I'm ready for Hollywood, right, Johnny?
These improvised films became cult classics and featured the strange array of low-life characters who hung around the factory, attracted by its atmosphere and notoriety. The drag queens Holly, Jackie, and Candy, and their leading man, the young hustler Joe Dallesandro, starred in films with titles like Trash, Flesh, and Heat, and Warhol encouraged them to act out their fantasies on screen.
You applied for welfare yesterday, Miss Santiago.
Yes.
Why did you apply for it?
Because we need it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a baby.
Yeah, I could see. When are you expecting it?
Next week.
I don't know. What you say?
Calm down. Calm your nerves now. Calm down now. Just calm down. Calm down. I'm trying to make this cool for you.
I'm afraid my parents have disowned me.
We're sponsoring a new band. It's called The Velvet Underground. Well, the whole thing is being auditioned tomorrow at 9 o'clock. And if it works out, it might be very glamorous.
Another regular visitor to the factory was Lou Reed. In 1966, Warhol dabbled in rock music, adopting Reed's band and styling them Andy Warhol's Velvet Underground. The band proved to be hugely influential, if not so successful financially. Reed's songs for the Velvet Underground, Candy Says, I'm Waiting for the Man, and Heroin, were contemporary accounts of life in and around the factory. Walk on the Wild Side, written after the Velvet Underground had split up, was a more sober recollection of those days.
Lou Reed was fascinated with trannies, transsexuals, particularly. He liked transvestites. He's fascinated with transvestites. Excuse me. But Lou, at one time, actually had Rachel. He had this girlfriend named Rachel, and she was a transsexual. And I mean, it's only natural that Lou Reed would write a song that had, you know, that three of the characters are drag queens.
Jackie Curtis was like the snappy redhead, you know, a real, you know, smart one. Candy was Jean Harlow, blonde. And I was the brunette. In the beginning, we were all friends, like in the early 60s, and when we all, you know, this was before any of the Warhol stuff, and we were really like close sisters. We were not like Lana Turner or Jean Harlow or Hedy Lamarr, which is what we wanted to be, or who we thought we were in our drugged, crazed minds. In our minds, we were women, but what we looked like was another story.
They were real lowlife. It was. The song is true. They really were on the wild side. Candy Darling really did give head on the roof of buildings at 4 o'clock in the morning to sailors who didn't know she wasn't a woman. You know, Jackie Curtis really was putting speed in her coffee first thing when she woke up in the morning, and absolutely had no idea that her beard was coming through her makeup because she couldn't even see her face. You know, Holly Woodlawn really was laying in the gutter and asking other bums to help her up. All these people became very glamorous by being just as trashy as they could possibly be, and were.
There she goes again. She's out on the streets again. She's down on her knees, my friend. But you know she'll never ask you please again. Now take a look, there's no tears in her eyes. She won't take it from just any guy. What can you do? You see her walking on down the street. Look at all your friends that's gonna meet. You better hit her.
Andy came into a luncheonette where I was working as a waitress. And he came over to me and said, you should be in movies.
With them eyes.
Yeah.
But the luncheonette was like 6 in the morning, and it was called Paradise Heaven or something. No, what was it called?
It was
Oh, it was the 12th of Always.
10th of Always.
We tried to be women so much. And I think that basically Andy just loved glamorous women. And around that time, he just didn't know any.
I'm the new girl in town. And I meet Rita Hayworth, Jane Fonda, Lana Turner, Kim Novak, all the glamour girls.
Candy was born James Lawrence Slattery on Long Island. Candy preferred always to be thought of as a woman, and when you were with her, she was extraordinarily beautiful. You never thought that this person could possibly be a man. She was extremely popular. All the artists loved her. The musicians, the writers, the directors, the poets, they all adored her. She was their mascot.
Don't disappoint me. Be beautiful. That's very good, very good. Give me a holler.
Andy
came from
out on the island. In the back room, she was everybody's darling. But she never lost her head. Even when she was given head, she says, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. Said, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. And the colored girls go do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
He loved drag queens, and a lot of people were finding it shocking that he was actually working, you know, with drag queens and real rent boys. You know, he's looking working with real, you know, real people who really live like that. And he loved to shock people. He loved to upset people.
Everything, all of that was kind of very humorous to him. And therefore, he was able to approach it humorously and be able to tell men who dressed in dresses, oh, you look like Lana Turner. You have to do a scene in my film. You know, boys who were so stoned on God knows what, you know, oh, you look like, you know, Errol Flynn, take your clothes off. And so he had this wonderful party, this wonderful time making films.
Andy Warhol came up to me in a bar. He made passes at me. And I just looked back at him and said, you bag.
Everybody tries to make films very well nowadays, so we go the opposite direction. We try to make them as badly as possible. A little bit in the tradition of the carry-on films. And we find if we put a lot of direction in the films, that gets in the way of the cast. And we're only interested in the cast and whatever they do. So as long as they keep talking and, taking the burden of the film on their personality, really, then we like that. In the meantime, we keep the direction out of it. I mean, when you direct films, you lose them. You lose a lot of... the old qualities that Hollywood gave us, which was stars. So we look for stars and let them do what they want.
We're trying to educate you here.
Don't you want to learn to be glamorous?
Candy. Here she's shown in chiffon negligee embroidered in silver. I love to kiss your satin smooth face. Too bad if dry skin causes your lines and wrinkles too soon.
Are you referring to me?
Jergens face cream.
Big stuff. He's big stuff, all right. There's Nothing Like Being Dull by Jackie Curtis.
Where's that? Wait.
I'm only kidding. I'm only kidding, Dan.
Jackie is just speeding away. Thought she was Jim Dean for a day. Then I guess she had to crash. Valium would have helped that patch. I said, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. I said, hey, honey, take a walk on the wild side. And the colored girls say,
Jackie was a drag queen. She also had an identity crisis because she thought she was James Dean. She thought James Dean's spirit had come back and possessed her body. But I can imagine James Dean's spirit coming back and taking possession of a drag queen's body. I don't think he'd do that, do you?
Candy tricked Jackie into putting on her first dress and said things like, oh, yes, Jackie, you look just like a woman. And of course, she didn't and never did. But she turned it into her own trick. And Andy would say, oh, but Jackie's so fabulous. Look at Jackie. And of course, it worked.
I think there's a bond between me and Andy. I don't know what it is, but, well, he called me his roommate on TV. And so you could be a roommate with somebody and not even live together. You just think alike. You're like roommates of the mind, you know.
They're exploiting you.
But no, I want to do it myself.
What are you anyways, a he or a she?
Jackie and Candy basically were the factory transvestites, Candy Darling and Jackie Curtis. But when Holly Woodlawn came along, she was very trashy. She'd take her clothes out of garbage bins. She was like drink and scream and roll around on the floor and throw her things, pull her dresses up in the air. And Warhol was absolutely fascinated with Holly Woodlawn. And Jackie and Candy were like, he's liking her now. You know, they were like livid.
Isn't she wretched?
She's tired.
She'll come to a bad end.
Jackie and Candy had just done Flesh, so I figured, well, why not join the bandwagon? I thought, oh, I'm going to be in a movie. I'm going to be in Hollywood. They're fabulous. Lights, cameras, action. There was two little lights and one camera. And Paul behind the camera, and then of course it was the set was this is a little bit cleaner, but it was a dump, and there was Joe, my big co-star, sweeping.
Hey, Joe. Oh, you're sweeping. Hey, the place looks fabulous. Wow, the place looks fabulous.
That look good?
It's about time.
I did it for you. You see, I fixed it all.
I don't believe you. I want you to meet Johnny. Johnny.
Hello, Johnny.
I met him outside the Fillmore. Nice to meet you. Nice. It's from Yonkers. Very nice.
Little Joe never once gave it away. Everybody had to pay and pay. A hustle here and a hustle there. New York City is the place where they said, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side.
What you like
side
to do is make bread, right? Make
I said, hey, Joe, take a walk on the wild
side. The easy way to
side
do it is, you know, what you're doing here, looking for those dirty old men as they walk by, right?
How much do you get on one job?
Well, I got this, one job. Most of your jobs
From $20 to $30, you know, most of them. But like, you can get one like I got today, right? Get one like that, where you make yourself $100, right?
That's crazy.
Oh, well, everybody's a little crazy.
I just happened to be in the same building that they were shooting something in, and friends of mine said, like, oh, Andy Warhol's downstairs shooting a movie. And I said, who's Andy Warhol? And they told me this famous artist. And we went down there to watch, and Paul came out from standing behind the camera with Andy and asked me to do a small scene. And Andy sat behind the camera with it, reading. He would always read a newspaper while he sat behind the camera, and all he did was click the camera on and off. That was it. You know, hear something interesting, click it on. Wasn't so interested, click it off. And I'd tell him stories, and he, you know, about my life and different things about me and who I was. And, you know, I mean, we'd always start off a film with, you know, we're going to make this film about a boxer. And, you know, the first day of shooting, you know, had nothing to do with that.
Now, that is like a start of a race. You begin like that, don't you? And then the thing comes, and you... And what do you do when you begin a race? You put your hands down first. And you've got to hold that. Is that a strain on you?
A little bit.
Because I might say you've got to hold that 10 minutes. You're around. And you're going to take off.
When I became involved with the people, the Warhol people, you know, it was a joke. The first film I ever did with them, and they came up to me and said, Joe, we'd like you to sign this release. And Paul did after I got done shooting. I looked at them real strangely and said, release for what? Oh, well, we're going to show this in cinemas. Yeah, right. Who would go and sit through this?
He's been coming here all day and giving us a hard time.
Well, a hard time. Anything, I have a better thing to do than waste my time here with you hippies.
Don't you call
me. I'd rather be another truck is wrong. Ten Negroes and help them.
Help you.
Touch me. I'm a bleeder.
Hit him. Go ahead, hit him. We'll get another welfare worker.
I was trying to be as natural as I could with the nudity. You know, that was a hard one to overcome. You know, trying to be relaxed. And, yeah, I'm okay with this. That I pretty much, it went unnoticed that, My co-stars were transvestites.
I mean, a number of your films have had things like fellatio and group sex and things that most people think of as perversions. Why is it that you have these things in your film?
Oh, well, I just always turn the camera on. I don't have anything to do with telling them what to do.
Yeah, but I mean, you take a camera to a certain place, don't you?
We happen to be, yeah, going to a certain place or something. It has nothing to do with what they do.
And, I mean, if you're doing the scene and you can't, if you don't feel well that day or you can't think of anything to say, it's just too bad. You know, maybe you won't do another scene.
I think the burden is just as much on Angie as it is on anyone else, if not more so. Because that's the name that's mentioned more often. And that's the name on my left arm.
Creating real stars. I don't think he really had a full grasp of it himself, what he was doing to these people's lives. He created these people who then could walk the streets of New York with a certain elevation above the rest of the scum because they were suddenly stars. They were still low-life street people panhandling. You didn't get much money, you know, for it. He would pay you, but not very much. It was really weird. It was really strange to see all those people just like hitting in my direction after I just left jail. Mobs of people going, and all they wanted was my autograph. I signed my first autograph that night. I was, when I saw my name in lights, it was like so old. It was like everything I had ever lived for. I just ran home screaming. I am a star.
Star is the heavenly body that comes out
Kansas City, a restaurant near the factory, is the gathering place for New York's underground. Almost every evening, Warhol's clan can be found here. Kansas City functions as both an unofficial casting agency and a public playground.
Oh God, that place was sick. It was wonderful. Yeah, so much happened back there. In one night, I mean, you would just see, like, you know, I mean, everybody from Patti Smith, Robert Mapplethorpe, Mick Jagger would be there, somebody else would be there, like James Fonda and Roger Vadim would be in Detroit, no. They'd be somewhere else. And of course, in the bathrooms, people were just doing drugs and of course, the music.
Lou, you have to remember, was pretty much of a lowlife then, too. He was there at Max's every night for years. Many, many nights so out of it that I had to put him in a taxi to send him home. Many, many nights that, you know, I mean, literally you had to hold his head while he was ill. But it's not like it was only him. It was, and it makes it sound disgusting, but it was so common.
Sugar Plum Fairy came and hit the streets, looking for soul food and a place to eat. Went to the Apollo, you should have seen him go, go, go. They said, hey, sugar, take a walk on the wild side. I said, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. All right.
If you're in the world of music or drugs, there is always a Sugar Plum Fairy. The one who delivers, who brings the stuff to you. Now, during this time from 64 to 70, there were two individuals I knew who were called the Sugar Plum Fairy as a nickname.
Huh.
Neither of the individuals who were the Sugar Plum Fairy were important to remember. Their only significance is that they became that character at that point. Lou, in Walk on the Wild Side, took poetic license. The Sugar Plum Fairy. The man, like in Heroin, or I'm Waiting for the Man. The guy who delivers to you. The Sugar Plum Fairy.
$6 in my hand.
to Lexington, 125. Feel sick and dirty, more dead than alive. I'm waiting for my man.
Lou himself was certainly going through heavy drug period during the whole time he was involved with Andy. There's no question about that. And there's also no question that Andy would have known about it. In fact, he wrote about it quite openly in some detail in Pompism, his memoir of the 60s. So, I mean, this scene was undoubtedly fueled by drugs.
Oh, pardon me, sir. It's furthest from my mind. I'm just looking forward to different in my mind.
A lot of the actors in the films, Flesh, Trash, Heat, Woman in Revolt, were on drugs all the time. Some of the people were on acid throughout the making of the movie. Every single scene was shot on acid. Some of them were on down. Some of them were smoking pot. Some of them were drinking. It was just an enormous amount. Andy himself was always very abstemious about drugs. He never actually took so-called illegal drugs. He took prescription drugs.
Are you saying that you are involved in this idea of making people more conscious of their lives, but you don't really want to get into their lives deeply? You just want to stir up.
Oh, yes, yeah. Don't want to get too involved.
See, like Andy said when we did that cultural center thing, me and Holly said, if only the three of you could have worked together. I said, well, it wasn't my fault. I'll work with anybody. But you see, when we were working at the factory, they pitted us against each other. I mean, I knew what they were doing, but I wanted to do my job, and that's all. I don't like all this other bullshit.
Why would they pit you against each other?
To make it interesting.
I call myself Candy Warhol now. Cashing in.
Well, at first we were all friends, we were all girlfriends, because we were all out in, you know, the gutter together, so to speak. But then once stardom hit, especially with the two of them, Candy just went to that place. She just wanted stardom so desperately. And Jackie was sort of like, I know, at that point I was like just the loose maniac. I just wanted to get laid and get high. You know, so I'm not making excuses for myself. I was having a good time, and I didn't give a shit about those two. I just wanted to have a fabulous time and be a model.
You know, these drag queens carry on and complain about all their problems and stuff. They don't really know what girls go through. I mean, they've never had a period.
But they take those pills.
I know, but they've never had a period. They can't really tell.
Say, I've come to hate my body and all that it requires in this world. Candy, say,
me, Andy Warhol.
Candy went to Europe in 71 to do two films for the German director, Werner Schroeder. Andy felt that Candy should have breasts. Candy was basically a little flat-chested. She went to this doctor on Central Park West for estrogen shots. The shot was called the Black Pill because the pill was black. She got a lot of these shots and she continued going to this doctor. And that particular pill was taken off the market in 75 as being carcinogenic. So in a way, I'm sure that's what did her in. She had cancer of the blood. If you take female hormones, that changes the shape of the blood cell. And I really feel, though people didn't say it at the time, I really feel that was the beginning of the end for her.
And then I'm making a film called Premiere. It's the story of three women. An up-and-coming young star, an old and dying star, which is the one that I play. And I'm kept alive by a doctor just to go to this premiere. And I die. a Swiss doctor who shoots me up with monkey glands, female hormones, and what does Ultra take?
I don't ever want to be pretty. I never want to be a fashion plate. I want to be a person to be reckoned with. You know, I want to really work. You know, I don't want to be just some beautiful thing.
Jackie Curtis continued to write plays. He was banished from the factory. Warhol had a new crowd of people up there who were like accountants. These were people who wore business suits. They were very elegant. They did not like Jackie Curtis dressed like a woman with a three-day beard growth. They weren't ready for Jackie's amphetamine humor or his alcoholic binges or his demands for money. So Jackie, who had the name of Andy Warhol carved on his arm, a tattoo, left the factory.
Jackie became addicted to heroin and she died. She OD'd.
It's my wife and it's my life because a man to my vein needs to be set on in my head and then I'm better.
We'll just do what we always did, that's all.
I saw some nice garbage up on 24th Street.
How do you know that? I'm Andy Warhol.
The end of the Warhol era came for me basically because of a deal that was made that I was unhappy with. Paul would say things like to other people that were interested in working with me I don't really think he could do a script. And Andy would tell people, oh, I thought he was a drug addict, you know. So, I mean, pretty much they weren't helping the further my career in any way. I mean, I'd probably work with them the rest of my life if it was left to them.
Piece of fan mail, right? And I don't open them, I just write appointments on them. And I throw it away, forget where the appointment was, who I met. That's what I do all day long.
I don't need to welfare anyway, man.
Bastard, we don't need anybody!
I don't know if I'll ever become a household name here in America, but my big thing is to land that television series that goes 50 episodes and, you know, you sit at home and collect the checks. It's pretty much my dream.
I'm going to fashion design school to be a... Actually, I'm studying... I want to become a costume designer. And... what else? Because I want to open up a little shop, a little haute couture shop, you know. Hollies, or whatever. Was it Holly of Hollywood? You're sitting in the middle of nowhere, you know, from nowhere. It's just like boom, boom, boom. And I'm in the strangest places. I mean, my parents heard it in Florida. And the fact that it's a classic, and it's just makes my panties twitter.
Holly came from Miami, FLA. Hitchhiked away across USA. Plucked her eyebrows on the way, shaved her legs, and then he was a she. She says, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. Said, hey, honey, take a walk on the wild side. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do